Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Middleware Technologies. Today we'll be looking at how we can configure Prometheus Datasource in Grafana using Ansible. So here in this video we will be trying to set up a Prometheus Datasource in Grafana console using a YAML definition file that we are going to upload with Ansible playbook, and we are also going to expose a particular port which is related to the Prometheus instance in order for Grafana to scrape or connect to that endpoint wherein the Prometheus instance is running. So let us see like how we can achieve this video. So I am currently working on Fedora 39 server with Ansible 2.16.2 running on my local system. So as a first step, we need to ensure that the Fluent-bit service is up and running. So this is basically a step that we have already done in our previous video, wherein we have seen like how we can collect system level metrics using Fluent-bit with a node exporter plugin as an input, wherein it will collect the system level metrics and expose it on a Prometheus exporter endpoint. So you can follow this video or blog wherein you can configure your Fluent-bit and get it up and running. So for now, like I'm going to just start up the Fluent-bit service to ensure that it is providing us with the required metrics. So let me go into my local machine. So here I'm just going to start up the Fluent-bit service, which is already configured with the node exporter plugin as input. So now if I go into my remote machine and look at the status of Fluent-bit service, it should be up and running and it is collecting the metrics from the system in the Prometheus format. Let me clear my screen and go into my documentation. The second step is we need to ensure that a Prometheus instance is up and running, which is basically going to scrape the endpoint that is exposed by the Fluent-bit. So here in this step, basically like we have done this in the previous video wherein we have seen how we can install and configure Prometheus with Fluent-bit metrics endpoint. So you can just follow the following blog with the corresponding video wherein you can configure your Prometheus instance with the Fluent-bit endpoint as the scraping endpoint. So for now, I'm going to just start up the Prometheus service. So let me go into my local machine and go to the Prometheus project. And I'm going to start up the Prometheus instance. So now the Prometheus instance is up and running. You can just verify it on the remote machine. So Prometheus is up and running, and you can just also go to the browser and try to access the following URL on port 2121, and you should be able to see the Prometheus portal up and running. Now let us go into our documentation. As a part of third step, we need to ensure that the Grafana service is up and running. So here, like you can follow the following blog wherein we have seen like how we can install and configure Grafana using Ansible. And we have seen like how we can update the configuration file and restart the Grafana service. So for now, like I'm just going to go into my local machine and I'm going to my Grafana project and start up the Grafana instance. So now my Grafana instance is up and running. So you can see the Grafana service is up and running, and the Grafana portal runs by default on the port 3000. So let me go into my browser and try to access the portal on 3000 port. So in the previous video wherein we have set up the Grafana, we have already updated the default credentials by updating the default configuration file. So you can just go so basically I am already logged in, but if I go to the login page again, so it doesn't accept the default credentials anymore. So I have already updated the default credentials with the new one. So now if we go into the settings, data sources, like here you can see like we have two data sources already configured. So let me delete them and we will try to recreate them. So right now like we are not able to see the delete button enabled over here. The reason being like these data sources have been configured using the YAML definition file which are uploaded into the Grafana service configuration. So if I go into the etc Grafana provisioning data sources, let me go into this with the root user. So this file is present, so that is why like we are not able to delete the configuration over here. Okay, so what we will do is we will try to create a new data source with a new name. So let me go into my local machine and let me open the project in VS Code. So now what we are going to look at is the step 4 wherein we are going to configure the Grafana Prometheus data source. So for this, let us try to go through the configuration wherein we have created a template file, that is Prometheus.yaml definition file, which will actually create a data source of type Prometheus with the following endpoint, which is it is going to scrape. So this is basically the Prometheus instance wherein it is scraping the endpoint that is exposed by the Fluent-bit on port 21 Fluent-bit. But Prometheus instance is running on 2121 and the scrape endpoint is running on 2021. So here like we are going to provide the URL wherein the Prometheus instance is up and running, and these are some of the JSON data that we are going to provide as a part of this input for the request. So this is the YAML definition file, very basic YAML definition file that we are going to upload into the Grafana configuration in order to configure the Prometheus data source. So here like we are just going to provide a different name so that we can create a new data source. Now if we go into the defaults, like we have added the following new variable, that is Grafana data source template, which is referring to the Prometheus.yaml file, which we are going to upload using this tasks. So here in this task, this first task is basically uploading the default Grafana configuration file. Then we are uploading the Grafana Prometheus data source configuration file at the following location. This is basically etc Grafana provisioning data source, wherein we are uploading that Prometheus.yaml file and providing the following ownership and permission. And the last step basically is exposing the Grafana exposing the Grafana service to connect to port 2121, wherein the Prometheus instance is running. This is basically required in case we have SC Linux enabled. So in case you have SC Linux enabled, and if you haven't exposed that port, so you are going to get this ABC denied error. Basically it is not it is not going to allow Grafana server to connect on any port other than 3000. That is the default port with which SLinux is configured. So in case you want Grafana servers to connect to the Prometheus instance which is running on 2121, we need to update the SC manage ports for this Grafana Grafana underscore port underscore T. So this is basically done for systems wherein SC Linux is enabled. Now let us try to upload our configuration. So for that, let me go into my shell, clear my screen, and let me open my read my documents. So here, like what we are going to do is we are going to upload the configuration. Basically we will be referring this Grafana data source template with Prometheus.yaml file so that it will upload that specific configuration file. So now the data source configuration is uploaded, and now if you go and look into the Prometheus.yaml file, like you will see the data source configuration has been uploaded. This is the new data source that we are going to set up. Now let us go into our shell and try to restart the Grafana service. So for that, I'm just going to run the following playbook. So we have restarted our service. Just ensure that the Grafana service is up and running and it is not failed. So our Grafana service is up and running. Now it is time to look at the configuration. So if you go into the settings data source, like here you will see the new data source has been created, and you will see the name is Prometheus 1234. The endpoint that it is going to collect the metrics is the Prometheus instance 2121, and here like the type and version is Prometheus. We have provided HTTP method that it is going to use in order to capture the metrics, that is host. Now if you do the test connection, the data source should be working. And now let us go into the explore from this data source, wherein basically we will be able to explore the metrics that we are collecting. Let me go into my documentation again So now we have looked at our configuration file. We have updated the configuration of the Prometheus data source using the Ansible playbook. That is step 5. So we have executed the playbook and uploaded the configuration and restart, and we need to restart the service also. Now we are going to, as a part of step 6, we have validated the Prometheus data source also, and as a part of step 7, now we need to analyze the metrics that we have collected. So here, like, what we are going to do is we are going to select one metric. So here, let me look for node CPU seconds total and add the rate to it and run the query. So here you can see it has started collecting the metrics for our CPU. So this is how, like, you will be able to configure the Prometheus data source, which is basically Prometheus endpoint collecting the metrics from the system, and we'll be able to analyze the metrics using Grafana. So this is what basically we wanted to look at in this video. I hope you enjoyed watching this video. Thank you all. Thanks for watching this video, and you guys have a great day.